So the first trailer for Thor: Love and Thunder is finally out, and let's react to it in 3, 2, 1. Wow, young Thor.
Wow. His hands were once used for battle.
Stormbreaker.
Now they're but humble tools for peace. I need to figure out
exactly where is he?
Who I am.
Yo, it's good to see. Oh, he's training. All right.
My own path.
Guardians.
My superheroing days are over.
Korg, this July. Yo, what? Yo, the new suit. What? Zeus!
Remember what I told you. You ever feel lost?
Alright, Asgard is now a country.
Not me.
Just listening.
That's it? Yo! Jane, look at her! Oh my god, look at that. Okay. That was really interesting and short. But it was enough for a teaser trailer, and I'm happy that they didn't show a lot. And yeah, I'm glad that we got a first look at Jane Foster as Mighty Thor. So yeah, let's talk about the trailer now. So the trailer finally came out. It was a longest time. It broke a record in Marvel Studios, you know, with the distance of the trailer to the movie. So yeah, they finally released a Thor: Love and Thunder teaser trailer, and it is a short one. But I'm actually glad. I'm always glad when they don't show us a lot about the story, you know, in the trailers. You know, they didn't even show us the villain. You know, we didn't know what's going on. There is no Gore, the God Butcher, you know. But at least we saw, you know, Jane Foster as Mighty Thor, and she looks really, really great. And from what I see from the trailer and from what I think that Thor is now in some kind of a retirement. You know, he is giving back. He does not want to be a warrior anymore, a superhero. So he's, I don't know, he's just trying to figure out who he is, and that's it as much as I can see. He's hanging out with the Guardians, you know, and I don't know what's going to happen later. I know that the plot synopsis is that the Gore, the God Butcher, comes here, you know, to kill all the gods, so maybe that's why Thor is going to interfere. But right now he is some kind of retirement, and we at the beginning of the trailer we saw how he is, you know, giving out the mantle. He is burying the you know, leaving it there. So yeah, we're gonna see what's gonna happen, to make him to become a warrior again, to the old Thor that you know and love before, you know. And it's probably just the God Butcher, and we got a new look at Zeus, you know, another god. We're gonna see a lot of gods in this movie, I think, and of course Zeus is going to be one of the gods that Gore the God Butcher is, you know, is trying to kill. So yeah, that's actually, as much as I can see, that's a good story for the movie, you know. But also I saw that Wakanda. No, not Wakanda. Asgard is now literally a country. They're like Valkyria is on some kind of a press. I don't know, but yeah, it is not right now literal country. New Asgard. So yeah, what I thought and my personal opinion of the trailer. I like the trailer. It has a weird, a little bit weird vibe. It is different from the other Thor movies that we saw. You know, the other Thor movies were a little bit more, you know, brutal and a little bit more serious, and you know, but we see this, and and it is a little bit different. It is closer to Thor Ragnarok. I'm not saying Thor Ragnarok is, it was also a really funny movie, and I know that they're going to do that also in this movie because many people like that in Thor Ragnarok. So yeah, I think I'm actually glad that they are doing it. I don't have any problems with that. But I also like the old Thor, especially the Thor from the first Thor movie. I think that he was, I don't know, in the Thor the Dark World and in the Thor he was a little bit more badass in the Avengers and everything. And now he's going into some retirement, and yeah, we'll see how the movie goes. Goes later, and if they are going to make more movies, you know, fifth and the sixth movie, I think they are going to give a solid movie for Jane Foster as Mighty Thor, you know, and Thor is just going to be a side character there. I think they are making another trilogy with Thor, and Chris Hemsworth himself said that he expects Thor to be for many more years in the MCU. So I'm really glad about that. They are keeping some of the original Avengers and making new stories for them. Like, you know, Hulk, he's now, I think, he's now appearing in She-Hulk, and he's rumored to get a movie, you know, a new movie with Mark Ruffalo. And what else? With Hawkeye, he got his own show. But he's also now in retirement. So yeah, I'm glad that they're at least keeping Thor, because Thor is one of my favorite Avengers, and I'm really glad that he's getting a fourth movie. From the Guardians, we saw Guardians in this trailer there. You know, we saw Peter Quill. They are always great. Guardians are always great. And I'm also happy that they're getting a third movie. And it is going to be their last movie. The director said that it's going to be a really sad movie, so probably half of Guardians are going to die. And I'm glad that we are getting a little bit more Guardians, at least in this movie, you know. I'm really glad that I keep them, because everyone loves Guardians, especially the first one. I mean, the both movies are great. I know that people are complaining about the second movie, but I really like the second movie. It is also a great movie. But yeah, I'm glad that Jane Foster is of course back, Natalie Portman is back, she's playing Jane Foster again, and she's now Mighty Thor. We're gonna see how they're gonna play. We saw Mjolnir, the broken Mjolnir, and it's now all fixed, and she has the broken Mjolnir, and we'll see how Thor is going to react to that. So yeah, that's it guys from this video. I hope you guys enjoyed it, and I'll see you guys in the next one.